let her...
Novak, may I tell you something quite sincerely? I like you. Really, I like you.
Well, thank you, Miss Bollage. I'll see you in the morning.
In the morning. Dear friend, I am so sorry about last night. It was a nightmare in every way. But together, you and I will laugh at last night someday. Ice cream. He brought me ice cream. Vanilla ice cream. Imagine that. Ice cream. And for the first time, we were together without a spat. Friendly. He was friendly. That isn't like him. I'm simply stunned.
I couldn't stand her. Couldn't stand her. I wouldn't have her. I never knew her. But now I do. And I could. And I would. And I know. She loves me. And to my amazement, I love it. Knowing that she loves me. She loves me. True, she doesn't show it. How could she when she doesn't know it? Yesterday she loathed me, bah! Now today she likes me, ha! And tomorrow, tomorrow, ah! watch her. I'm speechless, for I mustn't tell her. It's wrong now, but it won't be long now before my love discovers that she and I are lovers. Imagine how surprised she's bound to be. She loves me. She loves me. I love her. Isn't that a wonder? I wonder why I didn't want her. I want her, that's the thing that matters. And matters are improving daily. Yesterday I loathed her, woo. Now today I love her, woo. And tomorrow, tomorrow, oh, I'm tingling, such delicious tingles. I'm trembling, what the hell does that mean? I'm freezing, that's because it's cold out. But still I'm incandescent, and like some adolescent, I'd like to scrawl on every wall I see. She loves me. She loves me.
Your down payment.
Sherry, it's been grand knowing you, grand knowing you, grand being your friend. You've been kind, loyal, and so generous right down to the end. Please don't grieve watching me leave. That would be much too painful to stand. It's been fun. Now I must run, but it's been grand, perfectly grand. Ilona, farewell, Sherry, be brave, chin up. It's been sublime. You mustn't waste a precious moment over me. You don't have time. Just remember when you're lonely. There's a hollow in my pillow for you. And Phoebos, what can I say? Ah, Phoebos, no tears, be gay. You know, old friend, I'm in your debt. I owe you more than I can possibly repay. I won't forget. Give your wife a little kiss from Kodai. I never met her, but I will by and by. Though I hate leaving you, hate leaving your warm, intimate club. It's a small pleasure, but I'll treasure each warm, intimate snub. It's been grand, let me say, and let me say au revoir, not goodbye. For it's grand knowing you'll all be working for your friend. Could I?
You've never seen such a place. So many books. So much marble, so quiet. And suddenly all of my confidence dribbled away with a pitiful plop. My head was beginning to swim and my forehead was covered with cold perspiration. I started to reach for a book and my hand automatically came to a stop. I don't know how long I stood frozen, a victim of panic and mortification. A kindly voice, a gentle voice, whispered, pardon me.
Pardon me.
And there was this dear, sweet, clearly respectable, thickly bespectacled man just wondering, are you in need of some help? I said no. Yes, I am. The next thing you know, I'm sipping hot chocolate and telling my troubles to Paul, whose tender brown eyes kept sending compassionate looks. A trip to the library has made a new girl of me, for suddenly I can see the magic of books. I have to admit, in the back of my mind, I was praying he wouldn't get fresh. And all of the while I was wondering why an illiterate girl should attract him. Then all of a sudden he said that I couldn't go wrong with The Way of All Flesh. Of course it's a novel, but I didn't know, or I certainly wouldn't have smacked him. Well, he gave me a smile that I couldn't resist, and I knew at once how much I liked
Optometrist.
You know what this dear, sweet, slightly bespectacled gentleman said to me next? He said he could solve this problem of mine. I said, how? He said if I'd like, he'd willingly read to me some of his favorite things. Novel approach seemed highly suspicious and possibly dangerous too. I told myself, wait, think, dare you go up to his flat? What happens if things go wrong? It's obvious he's quite strong. He read to me all night long. Now how about that? Hard to believe how truly domestic and happily hopeful I feel. I picture my Paul there reading aloud as I cook. As long as he's there to read, there's quite a good chance indeed, a chance that I'll never need to open a book. Like someone else, someone I dimly recall. I know he'll only have eyes for me, my optometrist, Paul.
On the first day of Christmas, you enjoyed it. Will you be taking the bus home today, Miss Polish?
Yes, I will.
May I walk you to the bus stop?
I'd like that, Mr. Novak. Thank you.
12 drummers drumming.
12 drummers drumming.
11 pipers piping.
11 pipers piping.
10 lords are leaping.
9.
9 days to Christmas. 9 days to Christmas. Still enough time to do your Christmas shopping. These are the people who shop in time. Shop in time. Still enough time. Sensible people who organize the time at their disposal. 9 days to Christmas. 9 days to Christmas. Still enough time to do your Christmas shopping.
Are you in a very great hurry today, Miss Polish?
No, not at all.
Well, I thought maybe a cup of coffee on the way to the bus.
I'd love that, Mr. Novak.
Good, so would I.
8 maids are milking, 7 swans are swimming, 6 geese are laying.
9 golden rings.
4 days of Christmas, 4 days of Christmas. Just enough time to do your Christmas shopping. These are the people shopping time, just in time, many times.
And after all, it's just a box. You know, Miss Polish, I don't hate these boxes nearly as much as I used to. As a matter of fact, I wouldn't mind owning one myself.
You wouldn't?
No. If only to remind me of the first day you came here. Do you remember? I'll never forget it. What kind of a box, madam? Why, it's candy, and it's functional.
Oh, I was so terrified.
Oh.
And you were so awful. Did I really sound like that?
You sounded irresistible. As a matter of fact, I remember thinking, why, that's the kind of girl I could almost fall in love with.
But you were so awful.
I know.
And you never said anything.
Well, how could I? I knew how you felt about me.
Oh, but you didn't. I mean, really, you didn't. Because I was attracted to you. More than attracted.
Awful as I was?
What a shame you never spoke up.
And you.
Who knows what might have been?
I am so sorry about last night. It was a nightmare in every way. But together, you and I, we'll laugh at last night someday.
Dear friend, it's really true then. It's what I hoped for, that it was you.
Dear friend, I had to tell you, I couldn't stand it until you knew.
I was so anxious, I was afraid then.
I didn't
Fun, fairly well.